Hello Cloud Gurus and welcome to AWS This Week. It's so early in the year, but the announcements are still flowing from AWS. This week, AWS introduced the AWS Systems Manager Change Calendar. Amazon SES now lets you use existing IP address ranges. Amazon Translate has introduced batch translation, and we announce our Guru of the Week. You're watching AWS This Week with me, Nick Triantafillou. If you've never used it before, AWS Systems Manager is a service which gives you visibility and control of your infrastructure in AWS. Basically, it lets you automate operational tasks across all of your AWS resources. Well, this week, AWS have introduced the AWS Systems Manager Change Calendar, a feature which lets you schedule calendar events to ensure changes are allowed or blocked at the right times. If you have a huge marketing promotion or event where you expect there to be a high demand for your resources, you can automatically block any changes from occurring until that time has passed. And it can be done programmatically. For example, before an AWS Lambda function is invoked, which may change some resources, it can automatically check the calendar to see if it's a good time to do so. And if not, it won't execute. Very cool. The Amazon Simple Email Service, or SES, now has a feature where you can bring your own IP address. This is useful for companies who might have built a solid reputation for not sending spam from their own mail server IP addresses. If they did want to move to SES, they would have to rebuild that reputation and possibly risk being blacklisted if someone else using SES does start sending spam, a risk some companies wouldn't want to take. So now SES guarantees you can use your own IP range, and you will solely be responsible for your email delivery source address. Next up, Amazon Translate, the fully managed neural machine translation service, which has introduced batch translation. You're now able to translate up to 1 million text or HTML documents in an S3 bucket asynchronously using the batch translation service in a single API call, which is really useful for when your application doesn't need real-time translation. The batch translation service accepts a batch of up to 5 GB in size per API call, with each document not exceeding 1 MB. Now onto our Guru of the Week. This week, our winner is Asim Maltaire, an AWS solutions architect from Infosys in India. Congratulations, a t-shirt, sticker, and hand signed card are on their way to you. And you're also in the draw to win a free ticket to reInvent in 2020. If you'd like to win Guru of the Week, please be sure to check out this week's question of the week in our forum link below. All right, that's all from me. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus, and we'll see you next time.